What's going on, guys? This is LeoGuildwars, and today I've compiled an in-depth CoF Path 1 guide showing you how to make 8.5 gold in 1 hour. And it only consists of 5 steps, which are getting a group, speed efficient group, nourishment, token trading, and profit breakdown. Getting a group. Now what you're going to have to do is open an internet browser and go to guildwars2lfg.com. And essentially what this website is where people post looking for group or looking for more for their party for a particular dungeon. Now I highly recommend this method because it's much more efficient than just spamming on map chat. Step 2, speed efficiency, which covers berserker gear, team composition, nonetheless skill and trait allocation. Now to ensure you join a speedrun group, all you have to do is find a post that says they're looking for berserker characters in your desired dungeon, and make sure it says ping gear to ensure that every character in the party has high DPS gear. Now, in order for you to join the party, all you have to do is highlight the character name of the post and alt tab back into the game and paste it in join party. So what exactly is berserker gear? Essentially, berserker gear is a combination of 3 attributes, which consist of power, critical damage, and precision. Now from there, it helps your character achieve the highest DPS of its class, and this comes to play because it allows you to speedrun through the dungeon at a far faster rate than regular characters. Now on to team composition. The best team composition for speedruns for this particular dungeon would be 4 Zerker Warriors and 1 Zerker Mesmer. Now 4 Zerker Warriors are necessary because they have one of the highest DPS skill, which is the number 2, 100 Blades. 100 blade isn't the only thing that makes this class viable, it's the high survivability with high DPS output. Now why not just have 5 Zerker Warriors, you may ask? Well, it is also necessary to have 1 Zerker Mesmer because they have this one skill called Time Warp. Essentially what this skill does is it doubles the effect of 100 blade by its speed and its recharge time, which makes it far more superior to have 4 Zerker Warriors and 1 Zerker Mesmer over 5 Zerker Warriors. On to skill and trait allocation. Now you're going to have 30 in strength, 30 in arms, and 10 in discipline. And essentially I believe this is a default build for Zerkers. And you can play around with this. You can mainly put it for greatsword and dual axe. And for the discipline, all you have to do is make sure it's for the heightening focus, which is more critical chance. In terms of skill, it can vary from player to player, but I usually take On My Mark for great justice and banner discipline, but you can switch it out with strength depending on your team. And for the ultimate, I would use Signet of Rage, but then again, if no one has the other banner, I would take it. Now this just ensures more damage, so always take banners and double check if your teammates are using one or the other. And finally, we have step 3, which is nourishment. For nourishment, there's going to be the big 2, which is the Omnum Bar and the Potent Potion of Flame Legion Slaying. And what the Omnum Bar does is it really increases your revenue from the dungeon, and the Potent Potion of Flame Legion Slaying just allows you to do more damage and helps you pull through the dungeon much quicker if everyone is using it. Now I'm just going to cover the whole controversy of using Omnum Bars in a dungeon, because some people feel that spending the extra 3.9 silver for the bar isn't worth it. So let's look at the regular drop if you're not using any gold drop. From the first boss, you're going to get 10 silver, the first chest you're going to get 10 silver, and the last boss you're going to get 15 silver, giving you a total of 35 silver. Now with the Omnum Bar, the default gold drop is 40%, and you're going to get 14 silver from the first boss, 10 silver again from the first chest because gold drop rates don't affect chest opening, and finally the last boss you're going to get a huge increase of 21 silver. So you're going to get an extra 10 silver from using the Omnum Bar, but you got to take into account that the Omnum Bar costs 3.9 silver, so we're going to subtract that from the initial earning, and that's going to give you a total of 6.1 extra revenue. Now take into account that Omnum Bars do last for 20 minutes, so you're going to get a good 3 runs out of 1 Omnum Bar. So 6 times 3 is 18, so you're going to make 18 from initial price of 3.9 silver. So this is super highly recommended to do a dungeon with an Omnum Bar, and by no means should you be doing this without one. Now to actually maximize your gold find, there's also an add-on, which is the guided in infusion, which gives you another 20% gold from monsters, and this is achieved by getting ascended amulet with laurels. Now, you may be wondering what laurels are. Essentially, what laurels are is it's a new currency that they implemented, and you can check it out at the laurel merchant, which is in the bottom left corner of Lion's Arch. And when you go there, getting an ascended amulet costs 30 laurels, and getting the infusion costs 20 laurels. And make sure you get the DPS laurel if you're going for full Zerker. I, on the other hand, didn't, so that's my mistake. Anyways, in order for you to get laurels, there's two methods. The first is doing your daily. You can either do daily PvP or just a regular daily for PvE, and doing both won't give you two laurels. Doing either one will only give you one. And the final one is doing your monthly. And the same goes with doing both. Only one of them will give you the reward. But once you do your monthly, it's going to reward you with 10 laurels. Now, with the 60% extra gold from drop, you get another full 5 silver from one run. So that really adds up if you keep doing more consecutive runs. And this is really useful for those people that are farming for their legendaries just for the maximum gold output. We're close. This is the fourth step. Token trade-in. So after you ran several runs of Citadel Flame, you probably accumulated a lot of tokens. So from there, just go to Lion's Arch, bottom left corner, right above the Laurel Merchant, and yeah, just talk to NPC and open it up. It should be the first tab. Scroll down. I like to use heavy armor because you always get a chance of getting Aurichalcum ores when you break it down. And a cool method I found out is if you move the permission. So when you're about to buy something, they always give you a permission comp that says, are you sure you want to purchase whatever? And I usually put the okay or accept button right over the item, so I can just consistently just spamming and clicking the item and just running through my tokens. And from there, all you have to do is break it down with the master salvage kit, and you should get quite a bit of ectoplasms, and you just sell them for 19 silver each a pop. Bam, easy money. Alright guys, you made it to the last step. It's called profit breakdown. So first, we've got to understand how many runs we can do in 1 hour. And if you follow the previous step, you'd be in a speedrun group, and it would only take you 6 minutes, if not more, then you should join a new party. And it takes 6 minutes for one speedrun, and in 1 hour, there's 60 minutes, so a total run in 1 hour would be 10 runs. Now we have a fixed reference point of 10 runs in 1 hour. Now remember when I covered the fixed gold earning at 60%? That's with the Omnum Bar and the Infusion, the 40% plus the 20%, which equals 60%. And I covered that in one run, we got 50 silver. So obviously in 10 runs, that's 5 gold. Now on average, when you run this dungeon, you will come across blue and green drops. And I extrapolated from 50 runs, on average, you will get 10.1 blue or green drops from one run, which gives you a total of 10 silver because we're just going to average 1 silver per an item. So in 10 runs, you will get 101 drops, which is 1 gold. Now when you do dungeons, you will come across a bag of wondrous goods, and in one run you will get an average of 2 bags, so in 10 runs you will get 20 bags. In each of these bags you will get 3 tokens and 1 bag of coin, so 20 bags, 60 tokens, and 20 bags of coin. Now in one bag of coin you will get 2 to 4 silver, so we're just going to use a fixed point of 3 silver on average, so 20 bags of coin will give you 60 silver. Now keep in mind, you don't have to pause this video just to keep up, I'm just showing you guys the step-by-step process, and at the end I'm just going to forward all the final profits and add it up to one sum. Just a reminder, we're doing 10 runs because that's 1 hour, so every time you complete a dungeon you will get a reward, although if you complete a dungeon in less than 30 minutes there is a diminished return. Basically what a diminished return is, it prevents a player from farming or over farming a dungeon, so they're just going to half the reward each time you complete it. So the order of diminished return is 26 silver, 26, 13, 6, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, until there's a server reset. So the total is 83 silver from 10 runs. Now remember when I said diminished return affects the reward, this also applies to the tokens. So as I said, it halves each time. First you're going to get 60, 20, 10, 5, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, until there's a server reset. And the total is 107 tokens from 10 runs. Now, remember, we got tokens from the bags, so add this total with the total from the bags, which are 107 plus 60, gives you a grand total of 167 tokens per 10 runs. Now, when you go to the token vendor, one rare costs 30 tokens, so we have 167 tokens in total, which is 5 rares if you divide 30 by 100. 167 that will give you 5.5, but you can't split an item, so it's only 5 rares. After you've purchased the 5 rares, you can break it down with Master Salvage Kit or the Black Lion Salvage Kit, and there's a chance of getting 0 globs to 3 globs of ectoplasm. And remember, 1 glob is 19.8 silver, so which can take an average of 5 globs, which is 1 gold. We're almost there, guys, just bear with me. So after you do COF runs, there are uncertainties of making more money, and these uncertainties are rares, exotics, junks, and ritual bags. Now for the rares and exotics, I do have statistics for it, but junks and ritual bags I have not calculated. Anyways, for rares, in 1 hour you can get 0 to 5 rare, which is 0 to 1 gold, and for exotic there's 0 to 1 chance of getting one, which is 0 to 2 gold on average. And for junks and ritual bags, it's kind of random. I haven't actually done the stats for that, but I will not include this in the final breakdown of the profit. So taking that in consideration, you can always make a lot more than final profit I list at the end. And guys, this is what you guys been waiting for, the final profit. So keep in mind, this is 10 runs in 1 hour. So at 60% gold fine from monster, this is a fixed earning, so it's 5 gold, so you can't make no less than this. And for blues and greens, that's 1 gold. Bag of coins, that's 0.6 gold. And from the tokens, which are 5 globs, that's 1 gold. And from the dungeon reward, that's 0.83 gold. So the total profit is 8.43 gold on average. So you can make a little bit less than this or a lot more than this. Well guys, I'm glad you guys were able to stay tuned and stick with me throughout this whole video. I hope this is really useful for you new people out there. I'm sure a lot of people already know this method, but I just found that I should have just went into depth about it and explained it more to people that's unclear of how much money you can make from this dungeon. And yeah, I'm glad guys are here. It took me quite a while to make this video, so just please subscribe and give this a thumbs up just for the support. And hope you guys have fun farming, get that legendary or whatever you guys are farming. And these clips are just some of the farming videos I've captured. It's just showing you the rewards and how the run should look like. So hope you guys have fun. LeoGuildwars, over now.